All right, guys. Ooh, we have prepared a special meal for the dogs. Something that the dogs usually don't get. Today's a special day. And check out the meal that we've prepared.
Hey guys, welcome to my daily vlogs. Please subscribe.
Tuna. Cooked tuna, guys. They had pellets for breakfast, but this here is their lunch. And it's all cooked tuna. Like literally cooked fresh like this, not from the can. Yummy. Oh, doggies, we've got some tuna for ya.
You excited, Sice?
Okay, come. He loves it. He really loves it.
Sahara also loves it, but she's like, why are you vlogging? She's distracted.
Sahara, eat, go. Go eat. You were just eating.
Oh, okay. They want to switch.
Apparently, they always do this. It's almost like the grass is greener on the other side. But for these dogs, it's like the food is yummier on the other bowl.
Oh, what? Is it good? Is it the same? Is it better?
Ooh, guys. RJ is busy making something. Oh, it smells so good and it reminds me of my childhood. Guys, it's like Filipino style fruit salad. Okay, what are you putting?
Fruit cocktail.
Okay, but what is this?
All-purpose cream.
All-purpose cream. There's Eden cheese going in. Corn, nata de coco, which is like cocoa nut jelly. There's pieces of pineapple. Oh my gosh, my mouth is watering. Pieces of sliced papaya. Guys, when this is all mixed up, it tastes so good. And it just reminds me of like Filipino parties growing up.
Yeah, this is very Filipino.
Oh my, it looks so good. I can't wait to eat it.
A little bit of condensed milk.
Condensed milk. Wow, this is so like dairy-ish. Oh man, guys, if you've never tried this, look up a recipe online, Filipino fruit salad, and try making it. Trust me.
Yeah, you can mix any fruits, apples, slices.
Yeah, any fruits. Oh yeah, my parents used to put apples, like canned pears.
Raisins.
Raisins, yeah, grapes.
Or even grapes.
Oh my, yum. So once the cheese is in there, sliced into cubes, and you can also put shaved coconut, like meat. I remember growing up, my mom used to put that. Basically anything sweet can go in here, guys. But once that's all done, you put it in the fridge, you chill it, and then when it's done, oh, it's like super duper heaven. So good. OMG, guys, look. Okay, wait, I don't know if you can see it, but look carefully at the light. Look carefully at the light. Do you guys know what those are? RJ, what do they call that in Philippines? I think it's called gamo gamo. But anyways, you guys know what that is? Those are termites. Queens and kings, they're having a nuptial flight tonight. So all over the Philippines, nationwide, on this night, the reproductives, the alates, they're called, fly from their nests and they're attracted to lights and they mate. And then what happens is really, really beautiful, guys. So these are kings and queen termites, right? And they fly, they find each other, and then they drop to the ground. In this case, it would be our table. And then they pair up. They pair up for life. Like they get married, literally. And then what happens is the queen starts wandering, looking for a place to start her nest. And the male, sorry guys, I spilled a little sauce here. It's dry, we need to clean it. And the male follows right behind the queen. Literally, like the queen will be here and then the male, the king, will be right touching her butt. And they will travel in like this, like in a pair to go look for a new nest. And then they found their colony. They find a nook in a piece of wood and that's where they start their colony. And what's beautiful is they stayed paired up for life, guys. The king and queen termites live for like 30 years or so, and they're forever bonded. Termites, guys, in case you didn't know, are some of the few animals in this entire planet who are truly monogamous. Like they're paired up for life. Like right now is their nuptial flight. Tonight, they're going to decide their life partner. Isn't that crazy, guys? It's amazing. Okay, but don't worry because this happens every year here in the Philippines and we never have termites. Probably because in my place, it's not ideal to start a termite nest. Like they really have to look for decaying wood. Like, you know, like a decaying log or something. that's where they would start. So no, you don't have to be worried. Like literally in everybody's house tonight in the Philippines, they are seeing these termites flying. But isn't that beautiful, guys? Like, it's really a miracle. And this only happens for a couple of nights every year per species. So like this species, these flying alates have been waiting underground all year, like since last year, to fly tonight for their nuptial flight and to find their life partner. Isn't that amazing? They came out tonight. This is their night. This is their wedding night. This is a big day for them, guys. But sadly, they're going to die because they won't be able to have a termite nest at my place. And actually, I think I might catch them and feed them to my aunt. Sorry, guys.
Isn't that amazing, guys? Isn't the insect world amazing? So termites are not related to ants, although they do form colonies just like ants do. Termites are actually more related to cockroaches, believe it or not. But ants are very similar. However, there's a key difference. So when ants have their nuptial flights, like tonight, the males die after mating. There's no marriage, guys. So in the ant world, the queens, after they mate, they're like single widowed mothers. Isn't that crazy? They're like, they have to like be single mothers for the rest of their life. The males die. Like in the ant world, males are only used for mating. That's it. They die. They wait their whole life for that one nuptial flight night or day, and then they die after mating. Then the queens go on to start their own colonies by themselves. That's the key difference between termites and ants. Isn't that cool? Anyways, special night for the termites. I wish you all well, termites. Good morning, Mabu. Hi, squat. Good morning, Mabu. Hi, squat. Yes, it is a beautiful Saturday morning. I kind of slept in because RJ and I had beers last night. As you might have been able to tell while I was talking about the termites last night. But slept in and got up at 7 a.m. Did some ANTSCANADA work because tonight the new ANTSCANADA video is going up. You guys must watch it. And yeah, I'm done that. And I'm playing with the dogs now. Look.
Good morning, Sives. And Sahairs. Okay, no chewing the crate.
Thank goodness these things are built like tanks. Like, see, they love to chew this, but there's no damaging it. It's like really matibay, as they say in Filipino. It's very durable.
Right, Sahara? Did you sleep well? How about you, Sives? Did you sleep well?
How about you guys? Did you sleep well? Wow, what a beautiful day. Look, guys, so gorgeous, right? Even yesterday here in the Philippines was gorgeous. Like, the sun quality is, it's different at this time of the year. We're in our summer, and I could feel it, guys. Yesterday was super hot, and today is gonna be another hot day. But I just feel like the sun right now is, like, look at that. I don't know if you could see it through this camera, because this camera automatically color corrects, but man, it is like bright sun and like saturation turned up. It's just like the colors, they pop differently at this time of the year. I don't know, that's just me, but gorgeous sun, man, so beautiful. And obviously the dogs love sitting here in this area getting beams of sunlight from the window.
All right, guys, let's do our positive affirmation of the day.
For Saturday, April the 24th. Today, I accept all the good life has to offer with joy, pleasure, and gratitude. Ooh, love that. Hope you guys enjoyed today's positive affirmation and hope you accept all the good life has to offer with joy, pleasure, and gratitude.
Yes, look at that.
Guys, this here is my favorite lumpia. I've vlogged this a few times. Just defrosting it because gonna be eating this today. Lumpia is like Filipino egg roll or spring roll, rather. These particular lumpia, it's called lumpia ubod, which is coconut hearts or something or other. Right, guys? And this one contains pieces of carrot, ground pieces of pork as well. There is parsley in there. Oh, it's so good. And then I eat it with lots of raw garlic and spiced sweet vinegar. It's so delicious.
Now, guys. So I've got to make a minor diet change. Like, remember how I'm always like, yeah, I don't really diet, I just listen to my body. Well, in this case, I actually am going to cut out a lot of my carbs. I mean, this is like egg wrapping or rice flour wrapping, I'm not sure. So that's carbs, but I'm not gonna cut it out completely. But I need to like become more lean because something's come up this week, Mabuhay Squad. And oh my goodness, it is huge! Like, okay, well, it's pretty major. I need to become a bit more svelte, so I'm gonna up the vegetables, up the meats and fats, and then just slightly lower my, like, I'm not gonna eat chocolate. I'm not craving chocolate these days anyways. I'm gonna try to cut down on the sweets because Mabuhay Squad, a very important shoot is coming up. Mm-hmm. Mabuhay Squad, this week I have to shoot for